For 3B, they want you to find the equation of a line. So this looks a little bit different than A because now we're talking about perpendicular. So instead of giving 2 points, we're now working with parallel and perpendicular lines. So for this one, you want to make sure you know how to do both of these on the test. So for this, we're starting with this 2x minus 3y equals 4. And then we want to find the line that's perpendicular to this one, but then it passes through the point negative 2, 5, and then they want us to graph it. So first thing we want to do is figure out what the slope of the original line is. So we'll start with that, 2x minus 3y equals 4. In order to find out the slope of this one, we're basically going to solve for y, and whatever number is in front of the x is going to end up being our slope. So let's solve for this one. We're going to move the 2x over, the negative still stays with the with the 3 here, with the y, and you get negative 2x plus 4. You want to solve for y, which means you want to divide all these by negative 3. We get positive y equals positive 2/3 minus 4/3. The only thing that we care about is the 2/3 that's there. So we want to find a line that is perpendicular to that one. So when you have perpendicular, you have opposite reciprocal slope. So if it's 2/3, you want to take the opposite sign, so it's going to be negative, and you flip the fraction. So the m that we want to use is going to be negative 3/2. We also have this point that's provided that's going to be x1 and y1. So these three things you're going to put into the point slope formula, which is this one here, so you want to be familiar with this formula. And we're going to plug the information in. So we're going to put in the 5 in for y1, negative 3/2. Then we have x minus negative 2 will be plus 2 when we plug that one in. So this is going to be your point slope formula. Now the original question says find the equation of a line in slope intercept form. So we still have to take this and solve for y. And so we're going to first multiply by the negative 3/2. And we get negative 3/2 x, and then when we multiply it by the 2 here, the 2's are going to cancel, and you'll get negative 3. Then we're going to add 5 to both sides, and your equation that you'll eventually graph here is going to be, when we add 5, it's going to be negative 3/2 x plus 2. So this line is going to be perpendicular to the original one, and it passes through the point negative 2, 5. Now, something to keep in mind is instead of perpendicular, they might have parallel. If it said parallel, the difference would be that you would use a slope 2/3 instead of negative 3/2. So parallel means it's got to be the same slope. Perpendicular is opposite reciprocal slope. So pay close attention to what it asks in the question because it might be parallel or perpendicular, either one. Okay, but in this case, the answer is going to be this one. The last thing we want to do is graph. So I'll do that over here. You always begin with the y-intercept. So there's a 2 there. So we'll go up 2. And then the 3/2, I'm going to put the negative with the 3 here, which means that I'm going to go down 3 and to the right. Now, of course, the slope being the way it is here, it's written as negative 3/2. That could be written as negative 3 over 2 or 3 over negative 2. So you can use your slope as actually any of these three. So I'm purposely choosing the negative to be with the 3, and that way I can just go down 3. So I'm going to go down 3, and then I'll go to the right, and then make a dot right there. And then I just draw my line through. My line is going to try and draw it straight here. Okay, so that would be your answer. So when it says graph your equation, it means don't graph the original one. They're referring to graphing the answer that you get, which is this one right here.